Compassion means to have feelings for someone's problem and want to help just like Jesus. Mercy is the great kindness and generosity of God's forgiveness and love. As we celebrate Mass today, we want everyone in church to look for ways to show compassion and mercy at home.
Please rise as we begin our prayer together.
Morning.
Good morning, Father.
So let us pray together. Are you ready? Yes?
Yes?
Okay, so let us make the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So as we have come to Jesus to pray and to receive his body and blood into our hearts, we need to prepare ourselves. We make mistakes. Sometimes we may commit some small sins. So we need to ask forgiveness from the Lord so that we may prepare ourselves. So let us think about something that you have committed as a sin or a mistake and ask sorry from the Lord. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Keep your family, O Lord, schooled always in your good works, and so comfort them with your protection here as to lead them graciously to gifts on high. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
So let us be seated and we will listen to the first reading.
The first reading is from the book of Jeremiah. Then the people said, "Come, let's make plans against Jeremiah. Surely the teaching of the law by the priests will not be lost, and the advice from the wise man will still be with us. We will still have the words of the prophets, so let's ruin him by telling lies about him. We won't pay attention to anything he says."
Lord, listen to me. Listen to what my accusers are saying. Good should not be paid back with evil, but they have dug a pit in order to kill me. Lord, remember that I stood before you and asked you to do good things for these people. I asked you to turn your anger away from them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The response is, save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
Save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
You will free me from this snare they set for me, for you are my refuge. Into your hands I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
I hear the whispers of the crowd that frighten me from every side as they console together against me, plotting to take my life. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
But my trust is in you, O Lord. I say, you are my God. In your hands is my destiny. Rescue me from the clutches of my enemies and my persecutors. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness.
With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus was going up to Jerusalem, he took the 12 disciples aside by themselves and said to them on the way, "Behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and the scribes, and they will condemn him to death and hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and scourged and crucified, and he will be raised on the third day." Then the mother of the sons of Zebedee approached Jesus with her sons and did him homage, wishing to ask him for something. He said to her, "What do you wish?" She answered him, "Command that these two sons of mine sit one at your right and other at your left in your kingdom." Jesus said in reply, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the chalice that I am going to drink?" They said to him, "We can." He replied, "My chalice you will indeed drink, but to sit at my right and at my left, this is not mine to give, but is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at the two brothers. But Jesus summoned them and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and the great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you shall be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you shall be your slave. Just so, the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. So today, your class brought out the theme of compassion and mercy. And the one who, Gavin, you know, he introduced us to this theme at the beginning of the Mass. And he said, as we celebrate Mass today, we want everyone in church to look for ways to show compassion and mercy. So we need to know, how can we show compassion and mercy to others? Not only for all of you, but all those who are watching this celebration of the Holy Eucharist online, your friends in the school and their parents probably, so, and the teachers. So let us reflect on this aspect of compassion and mercy. You know, in the first reading, it is all about the prophet Jeremiah. He was doing a great things to the people of Israel. He prayed for them and he asked God so that God may show compassion towards these people, mercy towards these people. And what did the people do? People said that we need to do away with this person. We need to kill this person. We had to get him out from this, from the earth. So think of this. Somebody is doing good to you, and what we need to respond? How we need to respond? When someone does some good to me, I need to give back good, not evil. But then, what happens in the world every time? It does not happen. Sometimes we do good, but the people may not be understanding the good that we are doing. They may have their own way of thinking. And as a result, what happens? They think the one who is doing the good is an enemy. And as a result, they will do bad things to us. So one place of showing compassion and mercy is this. When people misunderstand us, we can show compassion and mercy towards those people. That is the one aspect. And a second thing in the gospel, what we can see, Jesus was talking about his death and suffering that he is going to undergo. He called all the 12 disciples and he told them, you know, Son of Man is going to be handed over. He is going to be crucified. He is going to be scourged. He will be condemned to death. The disciples, 12 of them, were listening all these things very nicely. But then we have a doubt whether they understood what Jesus said is all about, whether they understood or not. What happened immediately after that? One mother comes. Whose mother? Mother of the sons of Zebedee, that means John and James. Their mother comes and asks Jesus, can you make my both the children, one at the left and one at the right in your kingdom? That's a question. So disciples did not understand Jesus. Even the mother of the sons of Zebedee did not understand Jesus. But Jesus also trying to understand them, helping them about how to go through these situations of misunderstanding. And Jesus tells them very clearly, what is that? That we need to be a servant of others. Not that we are looking for great places or status in the society and powerful positions in the world. But Jesus says, be a servant, be a slave. That is what we know. We are done away with the slavery. When we speak about the slavery, what is that? People do not have rights. What the master says, commands the slave need to do. And we don't accept those things. But Jesus tells us, you know, you be a slave if you want to be first. And how is that works out? Yes, that is what Jesus speaking about, out of love. When you love somebody, what happens? We are willing to do anything for that person, like a slave, is it not? When you love your father, you love your mother, you love your friends, and you will be forgetting everything, and for out of my love for my parents, my father, mother, or my teachers, I am ready to do anything. I am ready to even undergo some suffering. And that is the way of being a slave Jesus speaking about. Out of love for God and for our neighbor, out of love for my father and my mother, out of love for my friends and my brothers and sisters, I am willing to undergo a little bit of suffering. You see how beautiful it is? And Jesus is speaking about that. When you become like that, trying to understand, trying to show compassion to my brothers and sisters and my parents, my teachers, out of love for them, we are doing the right thing. And that is what you already introduced us to at the beginning of this Mass. How to be compassionate and how to be merciful. Let us do it out of love for everything, willing to give our life. And that is what Jesus did. Jesus, though we are sinners, and people are sinners, human beings are sinners, but for that, those sinners, Jesus was willing to die on the cross with love for each and every one of us. That is what Jesus did. You see the crucifix there on the top. Now Jesus extended his hands, and his hands and his feet are nailed to the cross. How much pain, probably. He was like a slave. He was like a servant. He washed the feet of the disciples like a servant. Like a slave, he died on the cross. Think of that. He carried the cross like a slave. But it is for you and me, because out of love for the humanity. So, as we are celebrating this Mass, and as we are during the season of Lent, let us make sure that we do things out of love for one another and for God. Amen. Now let us all stand up and place our petitions before the Lord.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dear planet Earth, help us take good care of her by not littering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the world, that they work together to promote peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from COVID, other illnesses, and hunger, please bring them comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of the Saints, Faith, Hope, and Charity community, that we continue to grow in heart, mind, and soul. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the students in our school, help us to show our kindness toward one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the first responders who keep us safe, and for those in the military, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people and animals in Texas, please help them restore their beautiful state. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we place our petitions before you. Our children have brought out the prayers that are needed for the people around us. Bless their prayers. Accept each and every one of us. May our school, or the students, teachers, and other staff, may find joy and comfort in your love. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. So let us be seated.
Return to God. of grace and mercy, come seek the tender faithfulness of God. Return to God with all your heart, the source of grace and mercy. Come seek the tender faithfulness of God. Now the time of grace has come, the day of salvation. Come and learn now the way of our God. Return to God with all your heart, the source of grace and mercy. Come seek the tender faithfulness of God. I will take your heart of stone and place a heart within you, a heart of compassion and love. Return to God with all your heart, the source of grace and mercy. Come seek the tender faithfulness of God.
Let us stand up. Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, on the sacrificial gifts we offer you, and by this holy exchange, undo the bonds of our sins through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with the saints, faith, hope, and charity, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. So let us all stand up. The disciples of Jesus asked Jesus to teach them to pray. And Jesus taught one prayer. You know which is that prayer? What is that prayer Jesus taught his disciples? Yes, our Father. So let us together loudly say that prayer. Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Love.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus, hope for all, teach us to believe. Reach us, hope for all, in water, wine, and wheat.
Let us all stand up for the final prayer. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord our God, that what you have given us as the pledge of immortality may work for our eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So thank you very much for doing the wonderful celebration of this Mass with your active participation by reading the first reading and the word of God, the prayers of the faithful and the psalm, and you have done very well. So congratulations to the third graders. Thank you. God bless you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Here are the names of the Bulldogs celebrating their birthdays this week. Monday, March 1st, Kelly Dwyer, 3rd grade. Wednesday, March 3rd, Bliss Christopher, 4th grade, and Mrs. Sexton. Saturday, March 6th, Grace Dwyer, 8th grade. Let's pray the birthday blessing together. Loving God, you created all the people of the world, and you know each of us by name. We thank you for our friends who celebrate their birthdays this week. Bless them with your love and friendship, that they may grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace. May they love their families always and be ever faithful to their friends. Amen.